the target. McManus now with a 31-yard attempt to get the lead back up to 8. And that kick is good. Edelman is back deep for the first time. Amendola shaken up before. Edelman last year in the regular season had an 84-yard touchdown against the Broncos on a punt return. He fields it at the 35. Edelman, little stutter step move, and slips to one tackle. He gets all the way to the 50. They now take the Broncos to the Super Bowl if they can hold the Patriots back. They're chasing after Brady, who was able to get rid of it. It's ruled an incompletion on the field.
Tom Brady, and the guy's not getting open consistently enough.
3rd and 10, and again they're on Brady. He unloads it just in time. And Ware has been making plays in this quarter. He's been in the backfield a handful of times.
I've never seen Tom Brady under so much duress for such an extended period of time. I think by the end of the day, he'd been sacked 4 times.
The last 10 attempts by an opponent. This one could close it out. Brady, though, goes down the field to Gronkowski, and he has the football at the 10-yard line. Gronkowski has Talib on him at the top. 2nd and goal. Quickly over to Edelman. Edelman gets around Roby, and it's down to the 4. He looked his way. He's hit and throws incomplete. And now the AFC Championship's going to come down to this very next snap. With the game on the line, Brady in the pocket, end zone bound, and it is caught by Gronkowski to make it 20-18. He got away from the Denver defenders.
Double covered again.
Brady hangs on to his last gasp.
But they must regroup here because one stop takes them to the Super Bowl. Here's Brady rolling out, rolling and throwing. It's tipped in the air and it's intercepted. It's intercepted by Roby. He lost the football back at the 20, but it doesn't matter. It was tipped by Talib and the Denver defense. Denver wins it. Heading to Super Bowl 50.
Storyline today would be the biggest choke in the history of sports. That's what we witnessed. He's 2 plays away from losing 4 straight Super Bowls. Nobody ever thinks about that. And when I say he's the luckiest,
mixed up the number of guys that were coming after Tom Brady consistently. It was just a dominant performance by the Denver defense.
Came off the bench week 17. Got the Broncos restarted. Gave them a spark. Won the division, won the 1 seed.
So the dynasty is over.
Solidifying their team as an NFL dynasty.
The greatest of all time.
That's right, and I'm the best decision this organization has ever made.
He, what is he, 40? 41, 42, 80? He's doing the exact same thing he was a long time ago.
The following is a presentation of JSP Films.
Cam is the perfect possible replacement for Tom Brady because, listen, Cam Newton will not be afraid of that challenge.
Trick.
But they have the makings with a good offensive line to become a ground and pound offense with a little bit of a throw.
I love going against Cam. For one, he's one of the best players in the National Football League.
And Cam had one hellacious great year. Mm-hmm. He had an MVP, and he took a 15-1 team to the Super Bowl. Do I think Tom Brady's still going to go 12-4? I definitely think that they're going to go 12-4. What has Tom Brady been doing for the last 4 months? he has been violating sort of unwritten rules, right? He's been out there practicing in the hot Tampa sun.
It's a risk because he wants to show, okay, New England, you ain't want to do this.
Correct.
I'm going to show you that I still have something left.
Director Greg Hardy.
In those days, I talked to every freshman class that came in, looking at the issues of self-defeating attitudes and behaviors, relationship mastery, all kinds of crazy stuff. And then eventually, we're doing giant group therapy, building a team.
Before his sophomore season, Brady met with Harden for a private visit.
It's a rare moment when a kid will show up at my office saying, I need some support. He says, I want to be the starting quarterback at Michigan. And he had just lost 25 pounds from appendicitis. He was the skinniest kid you ever saw in your life, talking about he wanted to be a quarterback at Michigan. It went from there to helping him understand I could not get him a starting job at Michigan. There's nothing I could do about that. My job was to convince him that whether he ever started a game at Michigan, that he's got to be prepared to be the best player on the team. And if he's doing his job to be the absolute best possible competitor on that floor, on that field, period, he'll have a shot.
Brady was considering transferring after he lost the battle for the starting quarterback job to senior Brian Griese.
Everyone that wants to leave doesn't want to leave because they made a choice. They chose Michigan, and they want it to work. But not starting breaks your heart. And the fight is, how do you not take it personal? We recruited you, we loved you, and now you're gonna go somewhere else where they're gonna recruit you, they're gonna love you, and it's gonna be the same people, the same disposition, the same attitude, and you will have to prove yourself. Prove yourself here. Hey, your job is to fight. Don't complain, don't explain. If you want to cry, if you want to whine, you come in my office. But when you walk out this office, nobody is to see you sweat. Because in this world called football, you'll have a chance to be on the field. Will you be ready?
By his junior year, Brady had won the starting job. Still, he continued to meet with Harden.
He was in the office every week. He would show up Friday before a game, every game, and sit and prepare himself mentally. Remember, we're talking about a 20-year-old guy. This guy was hungry to be the best. He was trainable, coachable, and hungry.
And every player that's ever worn this helmet is counting on you. Because you guys are the ones that are lucky enough to play for Michigan. And not a lot of other kids around the country can do that. There's probably a lot of other kids that are sitting in meeting rooms across the country playing for some other teams. Not every kid is playing for Michigan. And this place is special to me. It's special to
the comeback kid. You didn't want to have to wait till the fourth quarter to bring the team back, but you did a tremendous job.
What better way to go as a fifth-year senior as an Orange Bowl victory?
I guarantee you, you will never regret drafting Tom Brady.
This is the draft report on you. Basically, it goes poor build, skinny, lacks great physical stature and strength,
lacks mobility and ability to avoid the rush, lacks a really strong arm, can't drive the ball downfield, does not throw a really tight spiral.
System type player who can get exposed if forced to ad lib.
And gets knocked down easily.
That kind of gets me fired up.
Former league MVP on his way to Foxborough.
The art of hindsight. The greatest team in the history of teams somehow get better while all the teams that are bad get worse. Cam Newton goes to the New England Patriots on a one-year prove-it deal.
I will take Bill Belichick and his coaching expertise. This is such a massive win for the Patriots.
What better opportunity than to go to a Super Bowl contender in New England that just lost Tom Brady and try to replace the greatest quarterback of all time in an offense that's hummed the last 20 years with Brady at the helm.
What have I become? My sweetest friend, everyone I know goes away in the end. and you could have it all. My empire of dirt, I will let you down. I will make you hurt.
The nitty gritty of Cam plus Belichick. What have I told you for 4 years here on Undisputed about Brady? He has swallowed all of the Napoleonic, dictatorial verbal abuse that Bill Belichick gave him for 20 years in New England. I'm talking about verbal abuse in film sessions when he constantly called out the quarterback for bad plays in front of the team.
Right.
And he constantly called out the quarterback and just ripped him up and down in front of the team during practice sessions.
In that offense, number 5 defense from number 32 to number 5 defense in 1 year with Todd Bowles. Now you get the GOAT. Tampa Bay Buccaneers about to go do some damage down there in the NFC South.
I am still right here, and you could have it all. My empire. I will let you down. I will make you hurt. I will keep myself. I would find a way.
Logan, you still have time.
Here, you know, where we're going. Trying to find that deeper purpose. To live it through sports in a very authentic way makes so much sense to me. Having these dreams and goals and aspirations and waking up and putting in the work and miracles happening and all this magic that sports creates. I'm in the middle of it. I get to live that through sports.
Yeah, no question. Tom's at an elite level. He'd be certainly at the very, very top of all the players that I coach intellectually, from an experience standpoint, and just decision-making. He can make split-second decisions better than anybody that I've ever seen. It's incredible some of the things that he processes, as I said, that might have happened a month ago, 3 years ago, and he instantaneously can make the right, do the right thing at the right time.
To do with this and this.
Correct.
Because I can outthink you, and I got heart that I will not quit. He passes Jerry, he passes LT, and a lot of people say Jim Brown. Tom Brady is the greatest football player in the 97-year history of the NFL.
It's trainable, coachable, and hungry.
That's the way you should win a Super Bowl.
But there is one constant throughout this whole 18 years. Two men who are the best at whatever has been done in the history of the NFL. Bill Belichick and Tom Brady. And through their hard work and great leadership, I am honored to say for the sixth time, we are all Patriots, and once again, the Patriots are world champions.
It amazes me about Tom Brady is the revolving door they've had at offensive line, at the wide receiver position, at the running back position.
Means they missed the most important part. Heart. They didn't understand what drives somebody.
Like in one
you ain't winning this battle.
Mm-hmm.
See, this is a chess player. Brady's that's what makes this guy so hard to defend.
Don't ever let somebody tell you you can't do something. You got a dream, you got to protect it. People can't do something themselves, they want to tell you you can't do it. You want something, go get it. Period.
Thank you so much for watching. My name is Justin Susan and I'm the editor of the video. The last Tom Brady video I made about a month and a half ago, you guys were so supportive in the comments. You guys asked for part two, so here's part two. That video really blew up. I had 40,000 views within 2 weeks and I never get that. I only get like usually 100, 200 views per video. But you guys were so supportive and kind. I really appreciate that. Please like and subscribe. And also, if you want to check out my Patreon page in the description, you can support me as a filmmaker. It's a platform where you can support content creators. I'd really appreciate that. It's in the description. But thank you so much for watching. Have a wonderful day. God bless. And thank you so much for watching, guys.
That was beautiful.